One can't light a cigar nowadays without thinking of fire. It's revolting.
Sometimes too, we sit down, but of us sleeping tirelessly.
Looking, listening, for that which is concealed to be revealed, before it is too late to put out the first few flickers threatening fire.
Many things may start a fire, but not every fire that starts is a work of inexorable fate.
The
destruction
of the city, I
am human.
Human.
All too human.
Mischief that wipes out all our fellow citizens.
Much can be avoided by common sense,
and very true.
It is unworthy of God and unworthy of man to call a stupidity fate, simply because it has happened.
The man who acts so
no longer deserves the name.
They ought to be strung up. Haven't I always said so? Another fire and the same old story as I live and breathe. A hawker who settles down in a house. A harmless hawker. They ought to be strung up.
Herr Biederman?
What is it?
He's still there.
Who?
The hawker who wants to speak to you.
Tell him I'm not at home.
That's what I told him, Herr Biederman, an hour ago. He says he knows you. I can't throw that man out, Herr Biederman. I simply can't.
Why not?
He's far too big and strong.
Oh, tell him and come and see me in my office tomorrow.
I've told him that, Herr Biederman, 3 times, but he isn't interested.
Why not?
He doesn't want hair tonic.
Then what does he want?
Humanity.
Oh, tell him if he doesn't beat it immediately, I shall come and throw him out of my own hands. Humanity. Oh, tell him to wait out in the hall, I'll be there in a few minutes. But if he's selling tracks or razor blades, I'm not hard-hearted, Anna, but... I'm not hard-hearted, you know that. But I shan't have him coming in here. I've told you that 100 times. Even if I had 3 beds free, I wouldn't consider it. Well, no one like me to nowadays.
Good evening. Your cigar, Herr Biederman.
I say, what's the meaning of this? I expressly told the maid for you to wait out in the hall. What possessed you, without asking?
Good evening.
Without asking?
My name is Schmitz. Joseph Schmitz. Good evening.
What do you want?
Oh, don't worry, Herr Biederman. I'm not a hawker.
What are you?
A wrestler, by trade.
Oh, a wrestler?
A heavyweight.
Oh,
well, that's to say I was.
And now?
I'm out of work. Oh, don't worry, Herr Biederman. I'm not here looking for work. On the contrary, I'm tired of wrestling. I just came in here to get out of the rain. It's warmer in here, you see. I hope I'm not disturbing you.
Would you like a cigar?
It's terrible being as big as I am, Herr Biederman. Everyone's so terrified of you.
To come to the point, what do you want?
My name is Schmitz.
So you said. Well, how do you do?
I'm homeless. I'm homeless.
Would you like a slice of bread?
Oh, that's all you've got.
Or a glass of wine, maybe.
Bread and wine? Only if I'm not disturbing you, Herbie. Only if I'm not disturbing you.
Anna!
The maid said that Herr Biedermann was going to throw me out himself, but I didn't believe that, not for one second.
Bring a second glass.
Very good.
And some bread, yes.
Very good.
And if you don't mind, Fräulein, a little bit of butter, maybe, or some cheese, or maybe some cold meat. But anything you happen to have, oh, a little bit of mustard, but only if you have it to hand.
Very good.
But don't put yourself out, Fräulein.
You know me, the maid said.
Oh, of course, Herr Biedermann, of course.
Where from?
Only from your best side. In the local, last night, you wouldn't have seen me sat in the corner, but everyone was so delighted every time you banged your fist on the table. My apologies.
What was I saying?
Oh, absolutely the right thing, Herr Biedermann. They ought to be stronger, the sooner the better. All these fire raisers. Take a seat.
Oh,
men like you, Herr Biedermann, that's what we need.
Well, yes, of course, but...
No buts, Herr Biedermann, no buts. You are one of the old brigade. You still have a positive outlook. That explains it.
No doubt.
You still have civil courage.
No doubt.
That explains it.
Explains what?
You still have a conscience, a real conscience. Everyone in the local could feel that.
Well, yes, yes, of course.
No, Herr Biedermann, not of course. Not of course at all. In the circus, where I wrestled, for example, that was before the circus burnt to the ground, our manager said to me, "Take a running jump at yourself, Joe." My name is Joe, something you know. "Take a running jump." This is what he would say. "All I need to keep my beast in check is a whip." That's the kind of person he was. "Conscience," he'd laugh. "Oh, if anybody's got a conscience, it's generally a guilty one." God rest his soul.
You mean he's dead?
Burned to death for the whole shoot.
Oh, I can't think what's keeping that girl.
I'm in no hurry, Herr Biedermann. And the maid has already told me you haven't a bed free.
The maid has already told me.
Why do you laugh?
Because there isn't a bed free. That's what everybody says the moment they see a homeless person, and I don't even want a bed.
No?
No, I'm used to sleeping on the floor. My father was a charcoal burner, you see, so I'm used to it. No buts, Herr Biedermann. No buts. I say you aren't one of these people who talk big in pubs because they're scared stiff. There isn't a bed free. That's what everybody says, but you, I believe, Herr Biedermann. Why would anybody be if nobody believed anyone? There is nothing but distrust in this world. Everybody thinks that everybody else is a fire raiser. You're the first person who has treated me like an arsonist.
Here's an ashtray.
Don't you agree? Most people believe in the fire department rather than in God.
What do you mean by that?
The truth.
Cold meat.
Oh, that'll do, Fräulein, that'll do. But, I've forgotten mustard.
Sorry.
You don't get a reception like this everywhere, Herr Biedermann. I can tell you, I have had some nasty experiences.
To him.
A man like me, a homeless and hungry, a man without a tie. So they say, the moment I'm across the threshold, come in, sit down. And then they call the police behind my back. What do you say to that? All I ask for is a roof over my head. And then they go and do that. It's revolting. I say, a man like me, a man who has wrestled his entire life. And then someone comes along who hasn't wrestled. I turn around, and this person grabbed me by the collar, just to have a look at him, and his shoulder's broken, eh? What do you think of that? Yeah.
Well, that's just the thing nowadays. You
You can't open a newspaper without reading another case of arson. And it's always the same story. A hawker who settles down in a loft, and the next day the whole house goes up in flames. I simply mean I understand people being a bit distrustful. Here, read this.
I haven't seen it.
A whole district. Read this.
Bosley?
Yes.
It would have been better with the chill off. It seems that the fire was started and planned in the same manner as last time.
Isn't it incredible?
That's why I don't read the newspapers.
How do you mean?
It's always the same.
Well, yes, of course, but that's no solution. Just not reading the newspaper, I mean, you have to know what lies in store for you.
Why?
Well, you just have to.
It will come, Herbieman. It will come. The judgment of God.
I think so.
I thank you, Fräulein. Thank you.
Is there anything else?
Not today. There is nothing I like better than mustard, you know. Excuse me. It seems the experts are saying that the fire was started and planned in the same manner as last time.
Herr Biedemann.
What is it?
Herr Connectling would like to speak to you.
Connectling? Now, Connectling?
He says...
Oh, I shouldn't dream of it, I say.
He says he can't understand you.
Why does he have to understand me?
He has a sick wife and three children.
Oh, I shouldn't dream of it, I say. Oh, Connectling, oh, damn it all. Let Herr Connectling see a solicitor. This is ridiculous. I won't have all this fuss just because I gave him the sack. And never in human history have we had such social insurance that we have today. Yes. Let Herr Connectling see a solicitor. I'll see a solicitor too. I share in his invention. Oh, Connectling can very well put his head in a gas oven for all I care. Or see a solicitor. If Connectling can afford to win or lose a case, let him try. Oh, tell her Connectling. I have a visitor. My apologies.
This is your home, Herr Biedemann?
Is the food all right?
Who would have thought that such a thing existed nowadays?
Mustard.
Humanity.
Oh.
Who would have thought that you wouldn't have just chucked me out into the street, out into the rain?
Well, you mustn't start thinking of me as inhuman, Herr Schmitz.
Herr Biedemann!
That's what Frau Connectling keeps saying.
If you were inhuman, Herr Biedemann, you would be giving me a place to stay tonight. That is obvious.
Yes, isn't it?
Even if it's just in the attic. Our wine should be just right. The police.
Oh, no. My wife. Come. Come this way. Put on one condition. No noise. My wife has a weak heart, you see. Come this way. Come.
And where's my husband? You know, we're not narrow-minded, Anna. I don't mind you having a sweetheart, but I won't have you hiding him in the house.
I haven't got a sweetheart, Frabulan.
Then whose was that rusty old bicycle by the front door? It gave me the fright of my life!
Here's the switch. If you get cold, there's a sheepskin rug somewhere, I think. I'll take off your shoes. No noise, for God's sake. Oh, Herr Schmitz.
Herr Biedemann?
Promise me that you're not really a fire raiser, are you?
Shh. My husband, Gottfried, has promised me personally that he'll go up to the attic every evening. Just to make sure that there's no fire raiser there. I mean, I'm awfully grateful. If he didn't, I should lie awake half the night.
Everyone knows we are there, and knows that a call will suffice.
on the light at this hour of the night.
Oh, whoa, I see, with nerves all on edge, distressed and sleepless, the wife.
There's someone coughing. Buckley? There's someone up there. Buckley! Then, as soon as there's any sign of trouble, they take a sleeping tablet.
Don't make such a game with your...
Oh, pretend, no. Give me some design, please.
I'm going.
Arsene!
I'm going.
And I can't. No, I can't. Oh, you want me to know? No, no, Arsene! You just mustn't leave like that. I mean, I didn't mean to offend you. I didn't say a word about you making a noise when you eat.
Madam's fault I have no manners. My father was a charcoal burner. Where was I to learn manners?
I don't mind the cold and the hungry, madam, but
no manners, no education, no culture.
I understand.
I'm going.
Oh, where to?
Out into the rain.
Oh, dear.
I'm used to it.
Oh, Smith, don't look at me like that. Your father was a charcoal burner. You must have had a...
No youth at all, madam. No youth at all. My mother died when I was seven.
Oh, Jude! Dennis, Jude!
Anything else?
I'm not taking you away, Archmiss. Really, I'm not. You misunderstand me, and it's terrible. There must be something I can do to persuade you. Come, Joe. Eat. I mean, what do you take us for? I really didn't notice that you make a noise when you eat. Even if I did, we said, no store-by appearances here, Hushmits. We're, not that type.
And God bless you for it.
The salt, darling. Do you want it? The salt.
It's true. Madam said nothing about wanting me to leave. That much is true. I do apologize for the misunderstanding.
How's the egg?
It's a bit soft.
Oh.
Willie says that private compassion doesn't exist anymore. And that there are no real human beings left, and the state has taken over everything. That's what Willie says. And the world has gone to the dogs. But he will open his eyes wide when he gets a breakfast like this, Willie will. Well, maybe that's him.
Who is Willie?
He has culture, madam. He was a waiter at the Metropole before it was burnt down.
A burnt down?
Head waiter.
And who is it?
A gentleman from the fire insurance.
And what does he want?
He says he has to look at the house. He's wearing a tail.
That must be Willie!
Well, look, girly!
But now there are two that are out of suspicion. Bicycles, that is to say, rusty ones, belong to someone. But who?
One since yesterday, another since today.
Whoa! What's more than that? Can we watch?
The faint-hearted sees much where there is nothing. Affrighted at the sight of his shadow falling over himself in excessive zeal. As in there he lives, he's angry, he's free.
I'm afraid it's dead. Let's check. Strictly speaking,
every citizen above a certain level of income is guilty of some offence. Don't worry. Open up! Open up! That doesn't sound like breakfast. Open up, I say, immediately!
It's never been like this before.
Herr Schmitz!
Ah, Herr Biedermann, I hope that silly rumbling didn't waken you. It shan't happen again.
Herr Schmitz!
It shan't happen again.
Leave my house! I said, leave my house!
When?
At once!
Why?
Or my wife will call the police and I can't and I won't stop her. And leave at once. Well, what are you waiting for? I don't want any argument.
I'm not saying anything, Herr Biedermann.
If you think I'll put up with any old thing, Herr Schmitz, just because you're a wrestler, and that rumbling all night long. Out! Out, I say, out!
He's never been like this before.
Gentlemen, my name is Eisenring. Wilhelm, Maria, Eisenring. How come there are suddenly two of you gentlemen?
You see?
Without asking!
You can't do things like that, Joe. Without asking, what a way to behave. Suddenly, there is two of us.
I'm beside myself.
You see? I told him so. Didn't I tell you so?
What are you thinking of? I mean to say, I'm the householder, gentlemen. What are you thinking of?
Answer the gentleman when he asks you a question.
Willie and I are friends.
So?
We went to school together, even as children.
Well?
Well, I thought...
What?
Well, I thought...
You didn't think at all. I understand your feelings perfectly well, Herr Biedermann. I mean, there's a limit to everything. You can't expect a householder to put up with absolutely everything. Didn't Joe ask you at all?
Not a word.
Joe!
Not a word.
And you're surprised when people throw you out into the street. This is no laughing matter, gentlemen. I'm in deadly earnest. My wife has a weak heart.
You see?
And she was awake half the night because of all the rumbling. And anyway, what are you two up to here? And what the devil are all these drums doing here? Here, look, here! What's this? What's this?
Drums?
Where did they come from?
Do you know where they come from, Willie?
They're imported, it says so on them.
Gentlemen!
It says so on them somewhere.
What an idea! My attic is full of drums! Piled up! Positively piled up!
That's just it.
What does that mean?
Joe, miscalculated. 35 by 45 feet, you said. But this attic isn't more than 1,000 square feet. I can't leave my drums out in the street, Herr Biedermann. You can understand that.
I don't understand anything. I'm speechless.
It says where they come from here.
Simply speechless.
I'll call him.
Petrol!
An official matter.
Is this true, gentlemen? Is this true?
That's what it says on the label.
What do you take me for? Do you imagine I can't read? I ask you, what's in these drums?
Petrol.
Stop joking. I'm asking you for the last time, what's in these drums? You know as well as I do that an attic isn't the place for petrol? Here, smell for yourselves. Is that petrol or isn't it? Well,
it is.
It is.
No doubt about it.
Are you crazy? My whole attic is full of petrol.
That's why we aren't smoking in here, Herr Biedermann.
And at a time like this, when there's a warning in every newspaper you open. My wife will get a heart attack if she sees this.
You see?
And don't keep saying, you see, all the time!
You can't expect a woman to put up with these things, Joe. A housewife. I'm a housewife.
Herr Biedermann!
Herr Schmitz,
Eisenring.
If you don't remove these drums at this moment, but this moment, I say!
Then you'll call the police.
Yes!
You see?
Herr Biedermann!
That was my last word.
Which one?
I won't stand for petrol in my attic! I won't stand for it, I say. Coming.
Oh, there you are, Herr Biedermann, there you are. You needn't come.
come down, I shan't keep you long.
Morning.
Good morning. It's about an accident.
Oh, good heavens.
An old man whose wife claimed he worked for you as an inventor. Well, he put his head in a gas oven last night. Oh. It's a Johann Knechtling, 11 Horse Lane. Do you know anyone by that name? Perhaps you'd like to talk about this in private, Herr Biedermann?
Yes.
It's no concern for your staff.
No. If anybody shall ask for me, gentlemen, I shall be at the police station. But I'll be back in a few moments, okay?
Herr Biedermann.
Sorry, Sally.
What's in these drums? If I may ask.
Hair tonic.
Hoverflaw!
Fresh hair for men!
Hoverflaw!
Try it today!
Restore your hair the Hoverflaw way! Hoverflaw!
Is he dead? What a charming fellow!
I told you this would happen!
But no mention of breakfast.
No, he's not been like that before.
You got the primer?
He's never been like that before.
Apart from the fact I have other worries just now.
about anything else nowadays. I could hook everyone we met for a fireraiser. How are things ever going to improve? You must have a little trust, a little goodwill, damn it all, that's what I think. I've only got one life, gentlemen. We can't always look on the black side, damn it all. A little trust. A little... I can't be scared the whole time, gentlemen. Do you really think I slept a wink last night? I'm no fool. Petrol is petrol. I got up in the middle of the night to climb up onto the cupboard and put my ear to the ceiling to see if I could hear what they were up to. They were snoring. Snoring! At least four times I got out of bed and onto that cupboard, peacefully snoring. And believe it or not, gentlemen, I even went out onto the landing in my pyjamas. I was so furious. I was just on the point of throwing the two scoundrels out along with their drums, with my own hands, ruthlessly in the middle of the night.
With your own hands?
Yes.
Ruthlessly?
Yes.
In the middle of the night?
Just on the point of doing so I was. If my wife hadn't got scared I should catch a cold or something. Just on the point of doing so I was.
How am I to explain it? He spent a sleepless night. Did it cross his mind that they might abuse the citizen's kindness? Seized with suspicion he was. Why was that?
What troubles beset a citizen who, though hard as nails in business, is elsewhere a charming fellow? Answers to the good
when it suits him.
Hoping that good will come from good nature actions. Sadly mistaken assumption.
Oh, what do you mean?
To us the place reeks of petrol.
Well, gentlemen, I can't smell anything.
Alas!
Nothing whatsoever.
Alas!
So you still ready as he to evil stenches?
Alas!
Oh, don't be so defeatist the whole time, gentlemen. And don't keep saying alas all the time. Oh, taxi! A taxi!
Citizen, where are you going?
What is he planning to do, the unhappy man? Afraid and reckless, I thought. Pale in the face. He hurried away, afraid and determined. But what is he planning to do?
So you saw ready as he to evil stenches. Alas!
Alack!
He feels shame towards the disaster.
What can he do to forestall the threatening disaster?
Will you do as I tell you?
A goose!
A goose, yes, goose!
Why take off your tie, Buckley?
If I shall report these two to the police, then I know I shall make enemies of them. One match, and a whole house will be up in flames. What's the good of that? But if I invite the two to supper, and they accept my invitation...
And what then?
Then we shall be friends.
Anna! You won't be having this evening off so late as before!
Disturbing you?
Of course not, Peterman. You're at home here.
I don't want to be in the way.
Where's our friend got to?
Joe, at work, the lazy dog. He didn't want to leave without breakfast. Oh. I sent him to get some woodwool.
Woodwool?
Woodwool carries the sparks fur.
What I was going to say, Horizon Ring.
You're going to throw us out again. You see, I was up all night. My sleeping tablets have all run out. It suddenly occurred to me that you don't have a bathroom up here.
We have the gutter.
As you like, gentlemen, as you like. It just occurred to me all night long that maybe if you want to use my bathroom, I told Anna to put out some towels for you. Why do you shake your head?
Where on earth has he put it?
Put what? Have you seen the primer?
Oh, don't worry about the bathroom, Helena.
Seriously, we didn't have a bathroom in prison either.
Prison?
Didn't Joe tell you I'd just come out of prison?
No.
Not a word.
No.
He speaks of nothing but himself all the time. I mean, there's people like that. Is it our fault he had such a tragic youth? Did you have a tragic youth, Herb Edelman?
I didn't. I went to university.
Father wanted me to be a lawyer.
Shut! Shut!
Tell me, honestly, Horizon Ringer, I didn't sleep a wink last night. There isn't really petrol in these drums, are there?
What do you think of us?
Oh, I'm only asking.
What do you take us for, Herb Edelman? Quite frankly, what do you take us for?
Oh, you mustn't start thinking I have no sense of humour, but really, some of the jokes you make are a bit much.
That's something we've learnt.
What is?
Joking is the third best method to hoodwinking people. The second best is sentimentality. The type of stuff our Joe goes in for. A childhood with charcoal burners in the forest, an orphanage, a circus, and so on. But the best and greatest method, in my opinion, to tell the plain and unvarnished truth. Oh. Oddly enough, no one believes it.
Sit down. But if you're frightened anything, I'm afraid you're wasting your time. Have you even said you would have nothing to do with me? Sit down. So we're going to be disappointed.
Ah, this keeping Joe so long. I only need to send him to get some woodwork. I hope they haven't nabbed him.
Nabbed him?
Why does that amuse you?
Just some of the words you use, Horizon Ring. You seem to me to come from another world.
Nabbed? I find it fascinating.
Another world, almost. In the circles in which people move today, hardly anyone ever gets nabbed.
That's because in such circles, people don't steal woodwork, Habibu. That's obvious. That's class distinction.
Nonsense.
You don't mean, Habibu.
I don't believe in class distinctions. You must have felt that, Horizon Ring. I'm not old-fashioned. On the contrary, I am genuinely sorry that among the lower classes, people still blabber on about class distinctions. Aren't we all creatures of the same creator nowadays? The rich and poor, the middle class too. Aren't we just flesh and blood, you and I?
Oh, Horizon Ring, I don't know whether you smoke also.
I don't say all men are equal, of course. You'll always get the competent and the incompetent, thank God. But why don't we just shake hands, you and I? A little idealism. A little. Don't you agree?
I may be frank, Herbie.
Please do.
If you won't take it amiss.
The franker, the better.
I mean, quite frankly, you ought to not be smoking in here.
Oh,
I mean, it's not for me to tell you what to do in your own home, Herb Edelman, but you understand.
Of course.
There it is!
Tell me, Horizon Ringer, what is it you're doing all the time, if I may ask?
What's that thing? The primer. And that's the fuse. There's better ones now, Joe says. Newer models, but those aren't in the arsenals yet. And it's out of the question to buy them. Everything connected with war is so terribly expensive. Nothing but the top quality.
Fuse, you say?
Detonating fuse. Would you be so kind to hold this for a second?
Joking apart.
Only for a moment. Thank you, Herb Edelman. Thank you very much.
No, Willie, no. You can't fool me. Not me. But I must say, you put put a great deal of trust in people's sense of humour. I can well and truly understand you get arrested every now and then if you make jokes like that. You have to find the right people. At the local, for instance. People fly off the handle if you so much as say you believe in the goodness in man. Ha! And I donated a sum to the fire brigade, so big I won't even tell you how much it was.
Ha! That's just because the good people are just as lost when the balloon really goes up.
Don't worry.
What's the matter, Herb Edwin? You look quite pale. I know. It's the smell. When you're not used to the smell of petrol, it can upset you. I'll open the window.
Thank you.
Herb Edwin!
The police again! Oh,
Herr Biedemann!
This isn't a police state.
What is it?
Herr Biedemann!
Coming! Oh, Horizon Ring, do you like goose?
Goose?
Goose, yes, goose.
Like me. Why?
With chestnut stuffing.
And red cabbage.
Yes, what I was going to say was, my wife and I, especially I, thought that maybe if you want to come for dinner tonight, you and Joe.
No.
Or tomorrow, if that's any better.
I don't think we'll be here tomorrow, Herr Biedemann. But tonight, with pleasure.
Shall we say 7 o'clock?
Herr Biedemann!
Is that a date?
It's a date. You can come out now, Doctor. You heard, didn't you? Joe and I have to go out to supper. You'll be on watch here. See, no one comes in the smokes before the right time. Got it? I often wonder what you're doing here along with us, Doctor. You get no real kick of the sparks and crackling flames, the sirens that are always too late, barking dogs and human cries and ashes. World reform. I don't like you academic types. But you know that. I told you that from the outset. There's no real fun in it. You lot are so ideological. So serious to the point of treachery. There's no real fun in it.
Ready are we. Carefully coiled are the hoses in accordance with regulations. Polished and greased and of brass is each windlass.
Everyone knows what disaster is.
An ill wind is blowing.
Everyone knows what disaster is.
Polished and carefully fixed to make sure that we have full pressure and life is our best as our bomb.
And the hydrants?
Ready!
Yes, I know. Yes, I know it's urgent. I'll let him know straight away. So, my husband has ordered a goose. And I'm supposed to roast it, just so we can get friendly with the lot up there. It's Saturday evening, as you can tell, and I can't get rid of the silly presentiment that maybe they're ringing for the last time. The bells of our city. You know, the bells of our city.
But...
I don't know, ladies, whether Gottlieb's always right, but this is what he once said. Of course they're scoundrels, but if I make enemies of them, then it's all up with our hair restorer. And no sooner was he in the party.
Perfect!
He's just always the same. I know my Godfrey. He's just too kind-hearted. Yes, just too kind-hearted.
One wearing glasses, a boy of good family doubtless, not given to envy, but full of book learning and pale.
No longer hope that good will come from good nature.
But resolved to perform any action, convinced as he is that the end justifies fully the means.
Hopeful he too, man of goodwill and of ill, cleaning his glasses to lengthen his view.
He sees in the drums full of fuel.
Not fuel.
He sees the idea. Tillall's blazing.
Good evening.
Man of
the
Wednesday!
Man of the Post!
Man of the
Letters! Good evening!
See you later!
father with the dead. As I said, just took the night for missing her. One come here, one so speak, Anna. Shut the window. As I know everything plain and simple, the free and easy atmosphere. What did these idiotic candelabra doing?
Well, we always had those heavy men.
Free and easy, plain and simple, I said. No ostentation. Nothing but cut glass and silver everywhere. What kind of impression is that going to make? Look at me, Anna. I'm in my oldest jacket. And you. You can leave the big poultry knife. We shall need that. But other than that, away with all this silver. And what's this for?
For the wine, Herbie.
Do we need it?
Yes, you need it, Herbie.
What do you mean, need? What I need is a sense of humanity and brotherhood. Away with it! And what's this? What have you got there?
Table napkin.
Damas!
We haven't any others.
There are whole tribes who live about table napkins. Tribes full of people like you and me. I ask myself what we need table napkins for at all.
Okay.
At all costs, no class distinctions. Mm. What's that wreath?
It's the one we ordered. And what do you think of that, Gottlieb? They've sent it here, and yet I wrote out the address myself in black and white. And they put the ribbon and everything the wrong way round.
The ribbon? What do you mean?
And the boy says they've sent the bill to Frau Knickling's house. Frau Knickling's? Look, the sign to our unforgettable Gottlieb Biedermann.
Oh, we're not accepting that. Oh, certainly not. They'll have to change it. Don't bother me now, Babette. I can't wait everywhere at once, damn it all.
Well, you
can't. Okay. We need to get rid of this tablecloth, Anna. You can help me. But as I said, I don't want any clothes tonight. I want you to come straight in without knocking, and put the pan on the table.
The pan?
There. Don't you see? That creates a completely different atmosphere. A bare wooden table, no fripperies, as at the Last Supper.
You mean I'm to bring the goose in the pan, Herr Biedermann? Herr Biedermann? And what wine shall I bring, Herr Biedermann?
Oh, don't worry about the wine, I shall get that.
Herr Biedermann?
What is it?
I haven't got a simple sweater. A simple sweater that makes me look like one of the family.
Oh, borrow one for my wife.
The red one or the yellow one?
It doesn't matter which one it is, so long as you look like one of the family. I don't want any show tonight, no cap and no apron. I make sure things don't look so dreadfully neat and tidy here. I'm going down to the cellar.
See that things don't look so dreadfully neat and tidy here indeed!
Good evening, Fräulein.
Why no woodwork?
Confiscated by the police. Anyone possessing or selling wood wool is arrested. It's a safety precaution being taken throughout the country.
Have you any matches?
Not me.
Nor me.
We'll have to ask him for some.
Biedermann.
Mustn't forget. Mmm, smells good.
You can think what you like about me, gentlemen. Just answer me one question. I tell myself, so long as they're bawling and boozing, they're not doing anything else. Oh, the best bottle in my cellar. If anyone had told me a week ago. Tell me honestly, gentlemen, when did you know for sure that they were fire raisers? It doesn't come the way you think. It comes first slowly, and then suddenly, suspicion. I was suspicious from the beginning. One is always suspicious. But what would have you done in my place, damn it all, and when? Oh, I must go up.
Oh, cotton waste! Cotton waste, get it? Cotton waste burns better still.
Oh. What's so funny about that?
Cotton waste? Do you not know what cotton waste is?
Yes.
You've no sense of humour, Babette. What can you do, gentlemen, when a person doesn't have a sense of humour?
All right, then. Explain the joke.
Well, it's like this. This morning, I asked Willie where Joe had got to. To which he said he sent Joe to get some woodwool. Woodwool got it. Just now, I asked Joe, had he been able to get any woodwool? To which he said no, but
he had been able to get cotton waste. And Willie said, cotton waste burns better still.
I got that.
Oh, you got that, did you?
And what's so funny about it?
Let's drink, gentlemen.
So, gentlemen, what's this all about?
You'll laugh a bit. I know you'll laugh. But this morning, we measured the fuse together, Willie and I.
The fuse?
The detonating fuse.
Seriously, gentlemen?
Seriously? Seriously? Seriously, she says. Don't let them kid you, Babette. I've told you our friends have other jokes, other circles. I've always told you. Next thing we know, they'll be asking me for matches. Oh, I tell you, our friends still take me for a nervous suburbanist who can be scared. Well then, cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
To our friendship. Well, we have no one waiting at our table, gentlemen. Just tuck in.
I can't eat anymore. I am stuffed.
Oh, go on, Joe. Not at the orphanage now. Your goose, darling, is first class.
Oh, I'm glad.
Goose and pomade. The only thing missing is a tablecloth.
Oh, did you hear that, Gottlieb?
But we can manage without it. A white one with a silver and damask. Yes. Anna! Damask with flowers in it, you know, like little frost flowers. We can manage without it, Herr Biedermann. We didn't have a tablecloth in prison, either. Anna!
In prison?
Oh, she got two.
You've been to prison?
Bring a tablecloth at once.
Very good.
And if you have something like finger bowls.
Very good.
I hope you don't find it childish, madam. But that's what the common people are like. Take Joe, for instance. He's never seen a knife rest before. The dream of his ruined life at a table laid with silver and cut glass.
Gottlieb, we have all that.
But we can manage without it.
As you wish.
I hope you won't take it amiss, madam. But when you've just come out of prison, after months without civilization, he's never seen such a thing before. It's the mass.
Well, what am I supposed to do with it?
Like this?
And Anna, where have our knife rests got you? Where are our knife rests?
Have been them
bring them here.
So take them away.
Bring them here, I say. Oh, where are they, in heaven's name?
You left out of pocket.
Don't excite yourself.
It's not my fault.
Don't excite yourself, Fräulein. South wind that does it. Let's drink, gentlemen. I used to be goose every day, you know, when I was a waiter, when you'd flit down the corridors with a dish in the palm of your hand. But then, where are we to wipe our fingers? Why? In our own hair, while others have cut finger bowls for the purpose. That's something I shall never forget. Do you know what trauma is?
No.
They explained it all to me in prison.
So, tell me, Carasmin, why did you go to prison?
Babette! Why did I go to prison?
One doesn't ask such questions.
I asked myself. I was a waiter, a little head waiter, you know, and suddenly they confused me for a big fire raiser. Oh. Arrested me in my own home. I was so taken aback that I did exactly as they told me. Don't worry, madam. I had seven absolutely charming policemen. When I said I had no time and had to go back to work, they said, your restaurant has been burnt down.
Burnt down?
Overnight.
Burnt down?
It's fine, I thought. I have time on my hands. The restaurant was nothing but a smouldering skeleton. I saw it as we drove past through the little windows in the police van. Carpe d'Echelon, 49. We had that too. The rest of the story, Joe will have to tell you, as I was in the anteroom playing with my handcuffs. Who should walk in but this fellow? Cheers, Joe.
Cheers, Willie.
Then what happened?
Are you the fire raiser? They asked him, and then they offered him a cigarette, to which he replied, I'm sorry, but I don't have any matches. Although, you take me
for a fire raiser!
Fire raiser, no!
A Gottlieb, who is it?
A doctor of philosophy.
Oh.
What's that thing there, Fräulein? That silver thing.
Candelabra.
Why are you hiding it?
Bring it here.
You said.
Bring it here, I say. What do you think of that, Joan? You have a candelabra and hide it. Silver, with candles on it. Have you any matches?
Not me.
Habedeman, we haven't any matches. Oh, really? We haven't. I have. Give them here. Oh, dear gentlemen, I'll do it. Leave it to me.
And what does the gentleman want? Oh, I can't make that out, madam. He's standing on the landing. He says he can't keep silent any longer.
Confidentially, he says.
Yes, he keeps saying he wants to make a disclosure.
Oh, well, what disclosure?
I can't make that out, madam, however often he tells me. He says he wants to dissociate himself.
It creates a completely different impression, all at once. Don't you agree, madam? Candlelight.
Oh, yes, yes.
I like atmosphere. You know, Horizon Ring, I am so glad to hear it. Jet! Don't make such a din with your dinner.
Oh, just let him be.
He has no manners, madam. I find it terribly embarrassing. But then, where was he to learn manners? From the charcoal burner's hut to the orphanage.
I know.
From the orphanage to the circus.
I know.
From the circus to the theatre.
Oh, no, I actually didn't know that, no.
Human destinies, madam, human destinies.
So you're in the theatre? Oh, and where was that?
Backstage.
Oh.
But yet he is gifted. Joe as a ghost. Have you seen that?
Oh, but not now.
Why not?
I was only with the theatre for a week before it was burned down.
Burned down?
Go on, don't be sharp.
Turn down.
Don't be sharp. Now, there's... See? Doesn't he look like a ghost?
I'm frightened.
Get him!
Can we?
That's theatrical language, madam. He learned it in the first week of rehearsals before the theatre was burned down, believe it or not.
Oh, can we stop talking about fires all the time?
Can we?
Ready?
Every man, every man. Be the man, be the man.
I think it's absolutely wonderful the way he does it.
Be the man, be the man.
You must ask, who are you? Otherwise, we would get through his words.
Every man, be the man.
Okay, then, who am I?
No! You must ask who he is.
Oh, I see.
Do you not hear me?
No, Joe, take it from the beginning.
Every man be the man.
Oh, are you, for example, deaf?
Try!
Oh, well, what else could it be?
You're supposed to ask, who are you? You could be Hamlet's ghost, or the stone guest, or a thingamajig, the guy who helps Macbeth.
Who calls me?
Carry on!
Gottlieb Biedermann!
If you ask him, he's talking to you.
Do you not hear me?
Okay, then, who are you?
I am the ghost of Kanakla!
Stop! You are an idiot! That's impossible! Kanakla was buried today!
Exactly!
It isn't really him. Puppies act in such bad taste.
It was the only thing I could think of.
Connected, of all people, an old and faithful collaborator of her even, to set him up in front of us, white and gleaming like the mass. Word of honour, madam, it isn't really him.
Yes.
Sorry.
Dad, sit down, gentlemen, let's sit down.
Is that everything now?
Would you like a cigar, gentlemen? Yes.
Is it?
You see how the universe is trembling. Thank you, Abiman. Thank you very much. You think that's funny, and you know full well that Kenneth put his head in the gas oven after all our Biederman had done for him. For 14 years he gave me connecting work, and that's the thanks.
Let's have no more talk about it, gentlemen.
That's the thanks for the goose!
Really, this is how we do it in our household.
Shall I something?
What?
London's burning, London's burning, fetch the engines,
Fetch the engines! Fire!
Yes.
Pour a water! London's burning! Fetch the engines! Fire! Pour a water! London's burning! Fetch the engines! Fire! Pour a water! London's burning!
Well then, cheers!
Cheers!
What was that? Sirens choking apart!
Generally how we do it. We get a fire engine off to some poor district on the outskirts, and when they come back and the balloon really goes up, they find their way back blocked.
Choking apart.
Oh, but that's how we do it.
Joking apart.
Moderation in everything. Can't you see my wife's as white as a sheet?
So what about you?
Anyhow, gentlemen, I can't laugh about that. Sirens are sirens. Somewhere everything has come to a stop. Somewhere the house is on fire. Otherwise, our fire engine phones won't be going out. Oh, where are you going?
We have to go.
Now?
I'm afraid so.
Not operation in everything, gentlemen. My wife has a weak heart. Let's have no more joking about arson.
But we're not joking, Herr Biedermann.
We're back.
Quite seriously.
Why don't you believe us?
Your house, Herr Biedermann, is very favourably situated. 5 ignition points around the gas holders, which are unfortunately guarded and a good south wind blowing.
It isn't true.
If you think we're fire raisers, Herr Biedermann, why don't you say so straight out?
I don't think you are fire raisers, gentlemen. You're being unfair to me. I don't think you are. Fire raisers.
Frost, your heart.
No.
What do you think we are, then?
My friends. Where are you going now?
It's time.
I swear it, gentlemen, by God.
By God?
Yes.
Willie doesn't believe in God no more than you do, Herr Biedermann. So you can swear until you're blue in the face.
What can I do to make you believe me?
Give us matches.
Do what?
We've none left.
You want me to?
If you don't think we're fire raisers.
Matches?
As a sign of trust, he means.
He hesitates, you see, he hesitates.
No, gentlemen, quiet now. Not in front of my wife.
The cop will be here in a moment. Have to go.
Yes, it's a shame, gentlemen. I don't want to make a song or dance about it, but why don't we call each other by our first names? Let's have another drink.
Yes. Tell your husband not to open another bottle on that account. There's no point now.
Nothing is too much, gentlemen. Just another drink, yes. Gottlieb.
Joe.
Gottlieb.
Really? All the same, we have to go.
Unfortunately.
Madam?
It was a delightful evening.
Just one more thing.
If there's anything I can do.
You know.
Is there anything you're going to give? Or...
the matches.
Oh, what on earth would that be now?
Out of the back, the sky from the kitchen and all the toys on fire.
Oh, at least it isn't here! What do you want?
I can stay silent no longer. The undersigned, since I was profoundly shocked by the events now taking place, and from our standpoint it seems to me, it would only be characterized as criminal, makes the following declaration to the public.